Genesis chapter 1, verse 2. And the earth was without form and void. It was not in the form it now is. Otherwise, it must have a form, as all matter has. It was a fluid matter. The watery parts were not separated from the earthy ones. And it was not put into the form of a terra aquas globe it is now, the sea apart and the earth by itself, but were mixed and blended together. It was, as both the Targums of Jonathan and Jerusalem paraphrase it, a waste and desert, empty and destitute of both men and beast, and it may be added, of fishes and fowls, and also of trees, herbs, and plants. It was as Ovid, K, calls it, a chassa, and an indigested mass of matter, and Hasiod, L, makes the chassa first to exist, and then the wide extended earth. And so, Orpheus, M, and others, and this is agreeable to the notion of various nations. The Chinese make a chassa to be the beginning of all things, out of which the immaterial being, God, made all things that consist of matter, which they distinguish into parts they call yin and yang, the one signifying hidden or imperfect, the other open and perfect, N. And so the Egyptians, according to Diodius Siculus, O, whose opinion he is supposed to give, thought the system of the universe had but one form, the heaven and earth, and the nature of them being mixed and blended together, until by degrees they separated and obtained the form they now have. The Phoenicians, as Santoniatha, P, relates, supposed the principle of the universe to be a dark and windy air, or the blast of a dark air, and a turbaned chaso surrounded with darkness, as follows. And darkness was upon the face of the deep, the whole fluid mass of earth and water mixed together. This abyss is explained by waters in the next clause, which seemed to be uppermost. And this was all a dark, turbid chaso, as before expressed, without any light or motion, till an agitation was made by the Spirit, as is next observed. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters, which covered the earth. Psalms 104, verse 6. The earthy particles being heaviest sunk lower, and the waters being lighter rose up above the others. Hence, Thales Q, the philosopher, makes water to be the beginning of all things, as do the Indian Brahmins, R, and Aristotle's, S, himself owes that this was the most ancient opinion concerning the origin of the universe, and observes that it was not only the opinion of Thales, but of those that were the most remote from the then present generation to which he lived, and of those who first wrote on divine things. And it is frequent in Hesiod and Homer to make Ocea, or the ocean, with Taphis to be the parents of generation. And so the scriptures represent the original earth as standing out of the water and consisting of it. 2 Peter 3:5. And upon the surface of these waters, before they were drained off the earth, quote, the Spirit of God moved, unquote, which is to be understood not of a wind, as Onkelos, Ibn Ezra, and many Jewish writers, as well as Christians, interpreted it, since the air, which the wind is a motion of, was not made until the second day. The Targums of Jonathan and Jerusalem call it the Spirit of Mercies, and by it is meant the Spirit of the Messiah, as many Jewish writers, T, call him, that is, the third person of the Blessed Trinity, who was concerned in the creation of all things, as in the garnishing of the heavens, so in bringing the confused matter of the earth and water into form and order. See Job 26, verse 13. This same Spirit, quote, moved, unquote, or brooded you, upon the face of the waters to impregnate them, as an hen upon eggs to hatch them, so he to separate the parts which were mixed together and give them a quickening virtue to produce living creatures in them. This sense and idea of the word are finely expressed by our poet, W. Some traces of this appear in the new or mind of Anaxagoras, which, when all things were mixed together, came and set them in order. X. And the, quote, mens, unquote, of Theos he calls God, which formed all things out of water. Y. And the, quote, spiritus intus alit, unquote, etc., of Virgil. And with this agrees what Hermes says, that there was an infinite darkness of the abyss or deep, and water, and a small ingredient spirit endued with a divine power were in the chassa, Z. And perhaps from hence is the mundane egg, or eggs of Orpheus, A. Or the firstborn or the first laid egg, out of which all things were formed, and which he borrowed from the Egyptians and Phoenicians, and they perhaps from the Jews, and which was reckoned by them a resemblance of the world. The Egyptians had a deity they called Sinim, out of whose mouth went forth an egg, which they interpreted of the world, B. And the Zophasmen of the Phoenicians, which were heavenly birds, were according to Sancho Neotho, C. of the form of an egg, and in the rites of Bacchus, they worshipped an egg as being an image of the world, as Macrobius D. says, and therefore he thought the question whether a hen or an egg was oldest was of some moment and deserved consideration. And the Chinese say, E., that the first man was produced out of the chassa as from an egg, the shell of which formed the heavens, the white the air, and the yolk the earth. And to this incubation of the spirit, or wind, or some would have it, is owing the windy egg of Aristophanes. F.